Hi, welcome to the concept library. Please watch the complete video. So this is our second video, second lecture for structure. And in this lecture, I am going to tell you, you know, you can see here, this is a big question. In this question, I have taken all types of loads, And you know, this kind of, if you are confused with notations and you are not able to solve this hogging, sagging, everything, I'll explain here. I'll make it already I have done this, so explanation will not take too much time, so just pay attention. Okay, so first see the closer look of the beam. This is hinge. Here we have hinge, and then here we have something, you know, vertical, and then from here we have 10 kilonewton. So if you are not clear with my writing, just go on my words. 10 kilonewton, and this distance is 1 meter, and from here to here this is 1 meter. After that, again at the gap of 1 meter, we have this kind of design, and in this direction 5 kilonewton, 1 meter, 1 meter, 5 kilonewton. Okay, so again at the gap of 1 meter, we have this arrangement, and here we have 10 kilonewton. This is one meter, this is also 1 meter. And after that we have UDL, uniformly distributed load, 2 kilonewton per meter. Unit is kilonewton per meter. So this gap is 2 meter. This gap is 2 meter. And then we have this load. This is called UVL, uniformly varying load. So this is 3 meter, this is 2 kilonewton per meter. And then at the gap of 1 meter, again we have load from downward, that is 10 kilonewton, and again at the gap of 1 meter we have a concentrated moment. This is called concentrated moment of 10 kilonewton meter. Then again at the gap of 1 meter we have another this thing, concentrated moment, but direction is this. So 10 kilonewton per meter, sorry, 10 kilonewton meter. So don't be confused when to take positive, when to take negative. This video is especially for that purpose only. Now how to convert the, so first of all we have to convert the given beam into its diagram, this kind of diagram, force diagram. So how to convert? So see, first of all this thing we have to convert, this is 10 kilonewton, so we have to remove this force from here, and we have to keep this force on the beam at this point. Okay, so if we are shifting any force from one point to another point, then one very important thing we have to take care, moment because of this force about this point we have to apply. So this force into this distance will give me moment of 10 into 1. Okay, so 10 kilonewton moment I'll be getting, 10 kilonewton meter moment I'll be getting. So that direction will be like this. So you can see here I have shifted moment force on the beam itself because that is horizontal, and then moment of 10 kilonewton meter, got it. And I have taken this gap as 1 meter, this green color one. Then again we have a couple here. Okay, so 5 kilonewton and 5 kilonewton, then this couple will give you moment of 5 into 2. This is 5 in this direction and this length is 2, or you can take 5 in this direction and this is 2. This is called couple. Okay, in case of couple, because we have two equal and opposite forces, so we don't have resultant force, but we have moment. That moment is, either you can go for, you know, total force is 10 and half distance is 1, so 10 into 1, or you can go for single force into complete distance, got it. So 10, and that is, you can see, clockwise. So I have taken here this clockwise, got it. And then we have to go for this diagram. In this diagram we have a straight line, then a straight line, and then here we have load. So this load will give me this kind of moment, right, this kind of moment. Right now don't think about hogging, sagging, I will explain further. Right now just go with me. So this 10 we have to shift here, and moment because of this 10 will be 10 into 1 that I have to shift here. Okay, done. Then come here. So this is UDL. Okay, uniformly distributed load. So how to find area because how to find concentrated load because of UDL? In that case, we have to find out area. You know, in some books, they represent, suppose this is a beam, they represent UDL like this, downwards arrows. So I have shown like this. So both are popular, anyone you can use, no problem, because we have to bother about concept. Now see, how to find the area of this? This total is, I mean, this height is 2. This is the meaning of this 2. 2 kilonewton per meter means maximum height is 2 and it is distributed over the length of 2 meter. So we have to find the area. So that area will be 2 into 2. That would be 4. So 4 I have shown here. But at which point? So that is nothing but the centroid of this thing. Okay. So this is a rectangle. So centroid will come exactly in between. So show the load here. So I have shown the load here down. Okay. Now come for the next thing. Here we have triangle. In this triangle, this is called UVL. Okay. The maximum height is 2 kilonewton per meter. So maximum height is 2 and this is 3. So find the area of the triangle. So that area will be 2 into 3 into half, right? Because in case of, we know, height into base by 2. So this is height, this is base, and no, I think, yeah, this is height and this is base. So 2 into 3 by 2 will give you 3. So this whole thing will convert into 3 kilonewton, and that 3 I have shown here as 3. Now, where to put this 3? So again, logic of centroid. So in case of triangle, this is centroid. This distance is 1 by 3 of the whole distance, or this distance is 2 by 3 of the whole distance. Okay. So this total is 3. So from this direction, this distance will be 1. Location of centroid will be 1. So what will I do? I will split this 3 into 2 and 1, right? Because 3 into 2 by 3 will be this distance, which is nothing but 2, and 3 into 1 by 3 will be this distance. Got it? Okay, so this will be the location of this UVL after making it point load. After this, we have another load, 10 kilonewton, which is upward. So I have shown here. And after that, we have a concentrated moment. I have shown here. We have concentrated moment again. I have shown here. And this is roller support. So roller support means what? If you have roller support, then you'll be having only normal reaction. You don't have this kind of horizontal reaction. Why? Because whatever beam is here, that beam can go in this direction, in this direction. So roller does not provide reaction in this direction or in this direction. Only beam cannot deflect upward or downward. Roller is having only this work. So because of that, you are having only vertical. So we are not sure about this right now. We are not sure this is the right direction or not. Even this can be the direction. So it depends on the entire load. Your answer is coming positive or negative. Okay. Now, after having this complete picture, actually I have taken a big beam because one example is sufficient. So I'm keeping little, you know, it's shaking, but I'll try to make it more proper. Fine. So our job is, we have to find the reactions on the supports or by the supports. Fine. Okay. So we have three static equilibrium equations. First equation is summation of all horizontal forces, force x means, generally we take x direction is horizontal direction, right? So forces in x direction, positive or negative, whatever, summation of all, zero. So you see, for this beam, at this hinge support, we are having two reactions. One is vertically upward, one is horizontal. So at point A, vertical direction, R at point A in vertical direction, R at point A in horizontal direction. So we got it, right? So at this point, we have horizontal force that is in this direction. So we take RAH. So I am taking RAH, and after that we have only one force, 10 kilonewton, which is in this direction. You can see here this direction, right? So that is minus 10 here. And at, you know, completely, if you will see, we don't have another horizontal force. So this itself is zero. So RAH we got 10 kilonewton. Okay, one thing is done. Now we have to bother about second static equilibrium equation. So forces in y direction. So our consideration will be upward forces I will take as negative, and downward forces I will take as positive. Okay, why mostly people take upward is negative and downward as positive, like I am taking. Why? Because mostly whenever you will see roll of the beam, work of the beam, mostly beam supports loads like this. You know, you see the bridges, you see whatever, loads will be downward. So mostly we take downward, mostly we handle downward loads. That's why our convention is positive for downward loads. Okay, so total loads, let's see from here. So our first load is RAV, which is upward. So upward load I have to take negative, so I have taken negative. Then we have another load. This is not the force, this is not the load, this is not the load. This is here at this point we have 10 newton downward, so this I will take positive. Moment I will not take, because this equation is for force, not for moment. After that I will come here, I will take plus 4 newton. Why? Because downward, so downward is plus. Then plus 3, then minus 10, and after that this I will not take because this is force equation, and this is RAB upward. So upward means negative RAB is equal to 0. From here I got the equation, this equation, RAV plus RBV is equal to 7. Okay, so now our third equation is very, very important. Here itself students are very, very confused. Third equation is about moment. So take moment at any point or about any point. So mostly we take moment about that point where we have more variables. So in this entire beam, either you take moment about RB, which is good, or you take about A, which is good. So here we have two variables. So mostly we should take moment about that end where we have more variables. More variables means this force will not give you any moment at this point, this force will not give you any moment at this point. That's why we take such point where we have more than one variable. Okay, just 1 minute. Yeah, so now we'll go for the equation. So first of all, you have to see the basic logic. See, one thing to mug up. What to mug up? If you are having this kind of moment direction, this is nothing but clockwise. Okay, this is clockwise. So clockwise you take negative, and if you are having anti-clockwise, take positive. Why this is hogging and why this is sagging, I will explain here. Okay, just I said to mug up because many students, they used to be confused after explaining a lot, they don't understand. So just mug up. If you're writing gate exam, just mug up. This is clockwise and this is anti-clockwise. But if you are able to understand, I hope I will let you to understand. Fine. Let's see. Suppose you have this black color beam and you have a load here. So because of this load, this beam will bend like this, right? So this shape is hogging shape, hogging structure. So if you are having hogging structure, so we take a negative moment because of hogging structure. And you see, because of this force, this beam is turning in this. So that's why we are saying this as clockwise. Okay, clockwise. So same concept. Either you say hogging or you say clockwise. So hogging or clockwise, we take negative. See, in our beam, this is clockwise, right? So in the equation, clockwise I will take as negative, but this is anti-clockwise, so I will take it positive. So now let's understand second one. So if you are having this kind of thing, directly given concentrated moment, take as negative. They both are having same significance, right? This is also clockwise, this is also clockwise. Only difference is this moment is produced because of point load, but this is direct the concentrated load, but both finally they are clockwise, so they are negative and they both have tendency to make the shape as Hawking structure. Now come here, if you are having this kind of beam and vertical force, so this vertical force make your beam to bend like this, and this shape is sagging shape. So this sagging shape, now you see this here, this load is making beam like from here to here, so this is the moment which is anti-clockwise moment, and anti-clockwise moment we take positive. So that's why I said, if you're able to understand this, very good, or else directly you mug up. Clockwise means hogging and that is negative, and sagging means positive. When I was doing in my graduation, so I made a trick. See, you know, nowadays we use smiley. So smiley means this is the face, smiling face. So smiling face means positive, right? Positive, this nose and this lips, positive. So smiling face is nothing but what kind of shape? Sagging shape. And sad shape means, you know, this kind of shape is sad shape. So negative, got it? So this trick I made. Okay, fine. Now let's understand this kind of thing. This one video is sufficient. After that, you will not be confused. Suppose, you know, it is crossing 16 minutes, it seems. Okay, but don't worry. I think it will go around 25 minutes. So see, this is beam and this kind of structure you have. So this load is downward. So because of this load, so first of all, you have to simplify the beam. How to simplify? This load, you have to shift at this point. So I am shifting the load here. Okay. Now, because I'm shifting the load from this point to this point, so what about this part? This load was producing moment also because of this distance. So that moment I have to apply here about this point. Got it? Yeah. So now why in this case? Because this will be having tendency to make the beam like this. So that's why I have shown like this. So again, this is what? This is clockwise. So clockwise is negative. Now, if you're having this kind of structure, then turn like this. And if you're having in this direction, this was, see the compare both. Compare this one and compare this one. Load is right side here, load is left side. So if your load is in left side, so this will be having tendency to turn beam like this, correct? Like this. So sagging shape, which is positive moment. Here again in this direction, okay? So which is negative moment. And this thing like this, right? Like this. So positive moment. I hope you got it. So now because of see, this is very messy, but I have done a lot of work out here, but no problem. I remember everything. I will explain everything. So our third is taking moment. That is very, very important. So after understanding everything, I hope you will be able to understand this. You do one thing. You draw a fresh diagram from the beginning of the video. Okay, pause the video, draw a fresh diagram, go to the beginning, and then come here. So summation of all moments about point A is zero for equilibrium. This is the third equilibrium equation, right? So now let's do it. So RB into 14 is positive. So where is RB? So in this beam, RB is here. So if you'll count the distance from A, then 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, this is 2 meter, 1 meter, 2 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, and then total. This total is coming 14. Okay, you can count again, no problem. So RB is coming as at 14 meter distance from RA. So that's why I have taken RB into 14, and then we have this thing. So this is clockwise or anti-clockwise? This is anti-clockwise. So I will take positive or negative. Anti-clockwise is positive. You see this thing here, anti-clockwise is positive. So I have taken positive, and then go for this thing. No doubt this is negative, so I have taken as negative. Then again go for this point load. So this point load will give you this kind of moment, right? This kind of moment. So this is positive or negative? So this is clockwise, anti-clockwise. So this is anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise means negative. But how much moment? So 10 into this entire distance. So this total distance was 14. So remove this 1, 2, 3. So this will be 11 will be remaining distance. So 10 into 11. So I have taken 10 into 11 as positive. And after that, go for this thing. So this load will give you this kind of moment. So this kind of moment means clockwise. So negative. So 3 into this distance. So negative moment, 3 into 9, 9 is the distance from A. Similarly, what about this 4? This 4 and this 3, same fashion, 4 into this distance, which is negative. And then at this point, see here you may confuse. See, this 10 is the force what I have shifted here, and because of this gap I got one moment also. So this 10 and this thing, they both I have to consider. So this 10 will give me some moment, and this moment also I have to add. So this moment is clockwise, so negative, and this 10 is also providing clockwise, so negative. So because of this load I will be having 10 into 1 1 2 3, 1 2 3, total distance 3 meters, so 10 into 3, that is negative, and this 10 is also negative. So I have written here the negative 10 and this. After that we have this moment also, that is minus 10, correct? And then we have positive moment, which is plus 10. So minus 10 and plus 10. So in this equation we have only one unknown, that is RB. So RB value will come as minus 23. And then come back to this equation. Where is the equation? This is the equation. RA plus RB is equal to 7. This equation and this equation will give you RA value, which is 30. Now see, this video has been this video is over now, but I want to explain what is the meaning of RB is negative. What is the meaning of this? See, I will explain here itself. Suppose you have a beam coming from here, and you have different types of load here, and here you have roller support. Now because of all these loadings at this end, this beam can have tendency to turn like this. At this end, because of this all loading, beam can have tendency to turn up in upward direction. If beam is going in upward direction, then this thing will pull the beam downward, right? Correct. So reaction will come downward. But if in the beginning itself you have considered reaction upward, that's why answer will come negative. Okay, but if this beam, this is roller support, because of several loads, this end is having tendency to go down. So to support the beam, this roller will apply the force upward. So if you will solve the force upward, it will come positive. But mostly we take this reaction upward direction, we don't bother beam is going in upward direction or in downward direction. But after finding this answer, if it came positive, it means beam has tendency to come down, that's why my support is upward, reaction is upward. But if I got negative, it means beam is going upward direction, I mean it is having tendency to deflect upward, that's why roller is pulling the beam downward. So reaction is downward, but because we considered upward, that's why answer is coming negative. I hope you got it. Okay, so now in next video we will discuss properly shear force and bending moment diagram. This question was very important, and this beam contains almost all types of loadings. Okay, so if you will understand, that's all done, you can clear your gate exam. So wait for the next or watch the next video, lecture 3. Thank you. And you have to hit the like button, you have to comment your doubt, you have to comment about the video, and subscribe the channel. Thank you so much.